Welcome to .NET MOOC. In this video, we will measure time taken by a C# program accurately with the help of a class called stopwatch, which is in the namespace system.diagnostics, which actually provides a set of methods and properties that you can use to accurately measure elapsed time. Let's do a demo program that shows how you can make use of stopwatch class to get the time taken by your code. First of all, you need to import system.diagnostics namespace, then make an object of the class stopwatch my timer. This is then you need to add or you need to start your timer by calling start function before your code and other execution. Here goes your code. Then code timer. Then you can see the time taken by the code between this start function and stop function. Time taken more time about elapsed. You can use elapsed or elapsed milliseconds or elapsed or elapsed ticks. You can add your code here and you will get the time taken to execute your code in this elapsed property. This is a program for summing integers from 1 to n using for loop. In addition to that, we are measuring the time taken by the for loop for different values of n. This is the function for summing integers 1 to n, and we have a stopwatch object my timer, and we started and we stop the timer here, and we call this function sum of 1000, sum of 100, sum of 10, sum of 30. When we run this, we can see the out. When n is equal to 1000, the time taken is more than any other values of n. This is another program to explain the concept of stopwatch in more detail. Actually, this is a program to sum integers from 1 to n using loop method and using equation. Here we have for loop for adding numbers from 1 to n, and we start with the timer here and stop, and we will get the time taken by this for loop here, and we have another method to sum integers from 1 to n using equation n into n plus 1 by 2, and you will get the time by restarting the timer before the equation and stop it here, and we will get the time taken by this equation. And we run this program and output 10,000 as the value of n, and we will get the output in both the methods. Sum is equal and time taken by the two method is far more than time taken by equation method. From this we can conclude that equation method is far better than loop method for adding integers from 1 to n. I have put related article links and download link for code used in demo explanation in video description. That's all. You can check my blog post about this topic from video description. Thanks for listening. Don't forget to subscribe my channel .NET Mob. Have a great day. Bye.